November 11th, 2020. Here at C&S Music School in Fukuoka, Japan, students were practicing a special song.
Do you know what this song means?
No.
It's about coronavirus. The chorus says, "We're all far away and can't see each other. But one day, life will bring us together. Things are very tough now. But let's definitely see each other soon, my friend."
Yuta Hihara is the composer of this song. As the day of the recording approaches, the first rehearsal was held on this day. In Fukuoka City, near the landmark Ohori Park, there is a music school that is attracting the attention of the music industry. There are four departments: vocals department, band department, entertainment department, and creative department. With 60 students, the C&S Music School is not a big school. But during the 20 years since the school was founded, 14 students have debuted, starting with Aoi Teshima, who has sung many films' theme songs, including Studio Ghibli movies. What's more, each of them is a truly unique artist with a strong individuality, drawing the attention of the industry. Naoyuki Mori is the president and founder of this school. Mori was originally a professional musician. He also sang at the live house Showa, where major artists like Yosui Inoue, The Tulips, and Tsuyoshi Nagabuchi sang in their early years. At the age of 30, Mori moved to Tokyo to become a professional singer. However, not being able to reach his goals, he returned to Fukuoka when he was 35 and abandoned his musical career.
If you really want to become a professional musician, the sooner the better to start your training. I think starting your musical training after high school is too late. That's why I decided to open a school that allows students to start training seriously right after graduating from middle school.
And in 2001, Mori opened the first music school in Kyushu that grants students a high school diploma. However,
once I opened the school, some students who had played truant and stopped going to school, or were a bit too wild and had been rejected by their schools, started coming to this school to get their high school diploma.
Haruhito Imamura is one student who received his high school diploma from C&S and is continuing his education in the advanced course. He was bullied throughout elementary and middle school.
Well, I knew that if I went to an ordinary high school, I'd see the same faces from middle school, and I wanted to avoid that. That's why I chose C&S. I love music, and I wouldn't have to see my old classmates. Most of all, everyone here is just so nice. We understand each other and tell each other, I've had tough times too. And like, if we see someone being alone, we say, hey, don't be alone, let's eat together. I think we don't let people be alone at the school.
There's a lot of love towards the students here. The teachers listen so carefully to what we say.
Tsukina Shiotari is another graduate of this school who currently attends the advanced course here, like Imamura. She also experienced bullying in junior high school. She became truant in November of her seventh grade and was so mentally damaged that she contemplated suicide.
I used to go see a psychiatrist, and I've had ups and downs, and I'd sometimes get real violent at night. I couldn't find a reason to live. I kept thinking, nothing good is going to happen even if I lived. All I could think about was death. I've attempted hanging myself, even tied a rope around my neck. Or I've run outside in my pajamas in the middle of winter around 10 p.m. barefoot. I ran to a highway near here and tried getting hit by a car. My mom and dad frantically came running to get me and dragged me home.
Despite experiencing such difficulties, Shiotari's current life is entirely different.
Well, when I get to school, my friends all come and see me. I have lots of friends whom I really get along with. And I'm always laughing with my teachers, too. We keep talking for like an hour after class. So I actually hate the weekend. I'm super sad when Friday comes because I can't go to school for 2 days.
Mori tells us a story about one student.
There was one student from Nagasaki whose parents would always tell me at parent-teacher meetings that they were scared to read the newspaper every day. They were worried that they may see their son on the third page for causing some kind of incident. But then on graduation day, his parents came to attend from Nagasaki. We had students give a short speech on stage, and when he received his diploma, he told his mother and father, "Thank you for everything. I'm so glad I was born as your son." Everyone in the hall started crying so hard. I was surprised too. It made me think that music can dramatically change the lives of students. When I first started this school, I intended to make a school for students who want to become professional musicians. But I gradually became excited to see students change and grow. I myself gradually changed. I decided that I wanted to create a school where students can transform themselves through music.
On this day, Mori was invited by a city community center to give a lecture about his experience.
One day, this student told me, "You probably don't understand how much it hurts not to be able to do what you want to do." He said, "Say there's a piece of cake in front of you. You want to eat it badly. Your parents and your teachers say you can eat it, but you just can't." And then he asked, "Do you know how painful that is?" I said, "I don't. I'm sorry." It's been about 10 years since then, and I think I still don't understand why they can't eat that cake. But at least now I can say, "Ah, I see that you want to eat it. You want to eat it, but you can't. That must be really painful."
And 2 weeks later, he held another lecture in Tokyo. It has been 20 years since Mori has built this school. His educational philosophy has rekindled hope in the lives of many children through music. And his reputation has spread all across Japan, encouraging educators and many parents who struggle with raising their children.
It was such a great lecture. I have a friend whose kid also plays truant, and I wish I could have brought her here. Maybe next time. I was so moved. Actually, my daughter is also truant and has stopped going to school. And I myself have been an advisor to truant students. So I felt like I went back to the basics. I almost cried hearing him talk today.
Olivier Urbain, the director of the Min-On Music Research Institute, heard about CNS and visited the school in 2018.
When Dr. Urbain visited, he told me that ever since they founded the Min-On Music Research Institute, they've held theoretical discussions and have done research on the role of music in education. But he was surprised to find out that at CNS, we've been putting such ideas into practice for almost 20 years. He said, "This is a school where individuals can transform themselves through music, and that transformation helps rebuild friendships and family relationships that were once broken." I thought it was interesting that he said, "CNS is a wonderful microcosm of world peace."
Dr. Urbain has visited Fukuoka numerous times after his first visit and did research on the musical education at CNS. He has presented some of the school's achievements to the world.
"I'm finally able to tell myself that what I've been doing and what I've accomplished in the past 20 years with our school has been valuable. Dr. Urbain has given me some confidence in that sense."
Early this year, Urbain suggested to Mori the creation of a musical exchange project between CNS students and high school students in Northern Ireland, in collaboration with Darren Ferguson, who runs the NGO Beyond Skin in Northern Ireland.
In Northern Ireland, also in the UK and in Europe. We wanted to find out how young people are able to find the courage and the hope and the resilience to overcome all kinds of challenges. Specifically, in Northern Ireland, the challenge is due to the legacy of the Troubles. It's still there, the conflict between Catholic and Protestant communities. Still, people are suffering because of that. And in Japan, it's more about bullying, about young people feeling excluded from society, feeling in opposition, conflicts with adults. So we wanted to know how music can help young people in both countries. So we got our concrete project, which is a music video created almost entirely by young people.
Very good. Excellent. So it's very exciting.
すごくもワクワクしています。Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yes. We'll give a good one.
The project seemed to have started out well. However, with the increased spread of the coronavirus, the C&S Music School was also forced to shut down.
When we originally set the goal of writing a song together, we were hoping to have a lot of opportunities for exchanges. We also talked about having students learn more about sustainable development goals, which the United Nations advocates to create a more sustainable environment. We wanted to work on projects that can have our students think of SDGs as their own issues. So, the goal was to deepen the understanding of each other through a global awareness and to create a song as a symbol of this collaboration. We also had talked about our students visiting Northern Ireland and students from Northern Ireland visiting Japan. But the actual value and emphasis of the project was more about the process. Then, with the coronavirus, intercultural exchange became physically impossible. So we needed a change of plans.
It's very unfortunate that we couldn't really enjoy the process of exchanges. However, if this pandemic continues, at least we learn a formula. We know now how we can create really amazing songs with schools in two different countries. Simply separate the tasks, 100% lyrics, 100% music, and communicate online and get it done. So at least we learned that.
Indeed, despite such hard times, students from both countries wrote a song together. The lyrics were written by the students of Northern Ireland.
We're going to look back in 2020. We're living through history. So we've been very pushing a lot of musical collaboration because I think that's very important to have that soundtrack. And it was quite interesting when the students, when the teacher Gary passed me on the lyrics from the students and I read through them, it was very moving. It was very moving because the lyrics, they weren't joyful lyrics, shall we say, because, you know, people are really struggling of being locked down. And at that time, the children weren't going to school. The school gates had been closed for quite a number of months.
The music was composed by the students of C&S. A competition was held, and Hihara's piece was selected.
I wanted everyone to sing this song with a smile on their face. I want them to feel the happiness of everyday life, just like usual. I want everyone to have fun, and imagine what it would be like when things get better.
Imamura has told us about why he thinks C&S is special. Here at C&S, there is not even a tiny bit of bullying.
You know, bullying is something that usually happens in any school. But at C&S, there's zero bullying. We're all so friendly to each other. Students of different grades also get along really well, and so do students and teachers. Since we're all here to pursue music, of course there are clashes sometimes, but it never degenerates into bullying. It always ends as an exchange of opinions.
What does Mori, the founder of the school, think about the role that music plays?
Well, music is in the heart, and music can come close to the heart. Some students try to sing well, but that doesn't reach the heart. We can approach them directly and say, you can't be superficial, you can't fake it. In that sense, we can have much deeper conversations than in usual academic environments. We can say things to each other that would otherwise be controversial if there wasn't music. So even a delinquent student would say something like, you're right, I can sometimes be like that. That's the power music has.
I think that it would have been difficult for me at this school too. If it wasn't for music, it would have been tough with just ordinary relationships. But music really helps. I think I'm getting stronger, but I tend to overthink. I'm like, maybe I said that too harshly. Or I'd wonder what they think about me. But when you have music to fall back on, if you practice hard, it all transfers into energy. And it goes in the right direction. So I think that's what creates a balance for me mentally.
What is the potential that music has? Dr. Urbain's research on C&S Music School continues. How should we live our lives? With no end in sight to the coronavirus pandemic, each of us must think about this question more deeply than ever. How can each individual lead a happy life? How can we accept each other and continue to live together? Within such difficult times, the youth of Northern Ireland and Japan have created a song together, offering hope for tomorrow. The song is called Far Away.
Down, you can go for me and say it's gonna be tonight. I'm missing the way that you hold me. My guess this is life. Oh.
I think just, oh my goodness, there's so much potential there. And obviously I visited C&S School, which, you know, I've really fond memories of my short time there. And I think this song is the start of the partnership. I think it's going to be a long-term partnership and development and relationships as well. So it'd be lovely to do more productions, more shared production. That's really good.